Hello everyone, very good morning to all. Today we are going to start chapter number 5 of the textbook, that is the 100 addresses part 1. Let us start it. Today, Monday, Venda Petrovsky was not in her seat, but nobody, not even Peggy and Madeline, the girls who started all the fun, noticed her absence. Usually Venda sat in the next seat, in the seat next to the last seat in the last row in the room number 13. She sat in the corner of the room where the rough boys who did not make good marks sat. The corner of the room where there was most scuffling of feet, most roars of laughter when anything funny was said, and most mud and dirt on the floor. My dear students, this paragraph talks about three girls. One is Venda. The remaining two are Peggy and Madeline. Venda is a girl from Russia, and Poland, nearby Russia. Peggy and Madeline, they are American girls. It was Monday and Venda was not in the class and nobody noticed her absence. Right? Venda generally वहाँ बैठती थी जहाँ पर बहुत ही नोटी बच्चे जिनकी एक क्रेडिट और रेपुटेशन अच्छी नहीं थी, तो बहुत ही मिस्चीवियस थी, उस जगह पर बैठती थी. Venda did not sit there because she was rough and noisy. On the contrary, she was very quiet, rarely said anything at all, and nobody had ever heard her laugh out loud. Sometimes she twisted her mouth into a crooked sort of smile, but that was all. Nobody knew exactly why Venda sat in that seat, unless it was because she came all the way from Bogenheit and her feet were usually kept with dry mud, but no one really thought much about Venda once she sat in the corner of the room. The time when they thought about Venda was outside of school hours, at noontime when they were coming back to school, or in the morning early before school began, when groups of two or three or even more would be talking and laughing on their way to the schoolyard, then sometimes they waited for Venda to have fun with her. Venda बहुत ही शांत girl है, एक तरह से बोले ना कि very quiet, peace loving. तो क्वेश्चन ये होता है कि तो वो पीछे क्यों बैठती? Why did she sit at the place where naughty children were sitting? The reason was she was coming from an area called Bogenheit. That was a poorly developed area, जो rough area था, muddy area था, unhygienic था, वहां से belong करता, right? हाँ, पहले लिखा है कि they did not notice the absence of Venda. वो कब Venda के बारे में सोचते थे? जब स्कूल आने का टाइम या स्कूल से जाने का टाइम. On the way they would make fun of this girl Venda. Then sometimes they waited for Venda to have fun with her. The next day, Tuesday, Venda was not in school either, and nobody noticed her absence again. Tuesday को भी absent है, किसी ने notice नहीं किया. But on Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie sat down front with other children who got good marks and who did not track in a whole lot of mud, did notice that Venda wasn't there. Peggy was the most popular girl in school. She was pretty, she had many pretty clothes, her hair was curly. Maddie was her closest friend. The reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Venda's absence was because Venda had made them late to school. They had waited and waited for Venda to have some fun with her. She just it had not come. They often waited for Venda Petrovsky to have fun with her. Wednesday को भी Peggy और Maddie जहाँ बैठे थे उन्होंने notice किया कि आज भी Venda नहीं है. लेकिन आज उन्होंने सीरियसली नोट किया. क्यों? बिकॉज आज उनके कार Venda को मजाक उड़ाने के लिए Venda के दे वर वेटिंग, और वो वेट करने में ही दे गॉट लेट, एंड सो मे बी दे वर स्कॉल्डेड बाय द टीचर कि इतना लेट क्यों. तो क्योंकि उनको डांट पड़ी तो उन्होंने नोटिस किया कि हाथ देखो नहीं आए कामो काम ने. तो हमेशा दे वर looking for an opportunity to make fun of Venda Petrovsky. Venda Petrovsky, most of the children in room 13 did not have names like that. They had names easy to say like Thomas, Smith or Alan. There was one boy named Bounce, Billy Bounce. And people thought that was funny, but not funny the same way that Petronsky was. Venda did not have any friends. She came to school alone, went up alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that did not hang right. It was clean, but it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. She did not have any friends, but a lot of girls talked to her. Sometimes they surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on the worn hard ground. "Venda," Peggy would say in a most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Mason. "Venda," she would say, giving one of her friends a nudge, "tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet?" Venda ka bahut funny naam tha, according to other people. Dusre bhi kuch naam the, Winnie Bounce and all, lekin wo Bounce itne funny naam nahi the. और वेंडा को फनी नाम के कारण उसकी मजाक उड़ाई। सेकंड पैराग्राफ से कि वेंडा का कोई फ्रेंड नहीं। She went to school and returned home alone. She always wore one dress, एक faded, बहुत ही dull हो गया हो ऐसा ब्लू कलर का एक ड्रेस था जो कभी आयरन नहीं हुआ था वो पहनती थी। Though she had no friend, फिर भी लोग उनसे बातें करते थे क्यों? They wanted to make fun. Peggy इस तरह से उसकी मजाक उड़ाती है, ये कहते हैं कि बेटा इतने ड्रेसेस है तुम्हारे पास, तुमने बोला था ना कि एक दिन कि तुम्हारे पास बहुत सारे हैं, तो टेल मी कितने हैं, ठीक है? 100, Venda would say. 100, exclaimed all little girls incredulously, and the little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. "Yeah, 100, all lined up," said Venda. Then her thin lips drew together in silence. "What are they like? All silk, I bet," said Peggy. "Yes, all silk, all color." "Velvet too?" "Velvet too. 100 dresses," Venda would repeat stolidly, "all lined up in my closet." Then they would let her go, and then before she had gone very far, they could not help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. 100 dresses. Obviously, the only dress Venda had was the blue one she wore every day. So why did she say she had 100? What a story. "How many shoes did you say you had?" 60 pairs, all lined up in my closet. Cries of exaggerated politeness greeted this. "All alike? Oh no. Every pair is different. All colors, all lined." Kitne dresses hai? Toh ke 100. Kitne shoes hai? Toh ke 60. Silk ka bhi hoga kapda? Toh ke haan, velvet ka. ये वेंडा की मजाक उड़ाने के लिए उनको उसको ऐसे क्वेश्चन किए जाते हैं। एंड जब वेंडा रिप्लाई तब ये लोग हंसते हैं ना, जबकि स्टोरी ये है कि वेंडा के पास एक ही ड्रेस है। पेगी हु हैड थॉट अप दिस गेम एंड मेडी हर इनसेपरेबल फ्रेंड वर ऑलवेज द लास्ट टू लीव। Finally, Venda would move up the street, her eyes dull and her mouth closed, itching her left shoulder every now and then in the funny way she had, finishing the walk to school alone. Peggy was not really cruel. She protected small children from bullies. She cried for hours if she saw an animal mistreated. If anybody had said to her, "Don't you think that is a cruel way to treat Venda?" she would have been very surprised. Cruel? Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? Anybody could tell that that was a lie. Why did she want to lie? And she wasn't just an ordinary person. Else, why did she have a name like that? Anyway, they never made her cry. As for Maddie, this business of asking Venda every day how many dresses, how many hats, how many this, how many that she had was bothering her. Maddie was poor herself. She usually wore somebody's hand-me-down clothes. Thank goodness, she did not live up on the bogey site or have a funny name. पेगी इतनी खराब नहीं है ऐसा लिखा। अगर खराब नहीं है तो why did she treat Venda in a rude manner? The reason is, according to Peggy, that why should Venda Petronsky tell lie? She has only one dress and she says she has 100 dresses lined up. पेगी अच्छी है, उसका एक और सबूत भी अंदर लिखा है कि अगर छोटे बच्चों को कोई मजाक उड़ाता है, कोई बड़ा बच्चा, तो she would fight for that small boy. वो अच्छी भी है, लेकिन वेंडा को, पेगी को एक ही प्रॉब्लम है कि इनको झूठ नहीं बोलना। मेडी जो उसकी फ्रेंड है, she is very poor, She generally wears the clothes which are given by others, hand-me-down clothes, यानी second user जो होता है, उसको जब मिलते हैं, मैंने पहन ली और मैंने किसी को दिए, तो hand-me-down clothes हुए उस बंदे के लिए. Maddie does not like Peggy teasing or behaving rudely with Wanda, but she is not able to do anything because she is also poor and she has a fear. कि आज ये लोग वेंडा की मजाक उड़ा रहे, मैं अगर कुछ बोलूंगी मेरी मजाक उड़ाई तो वगैरह. Sometimes when Peggy was asking Wanda those questions in that mocking polite मजाक उड़ाने के खातिर, लेकिन बहुत ही ढोंगी पोलाइटनेस. Maddie felt embarrassed and studied the marbles in the palm of her hand, rolling them around and saying nothing herself. Not that she felt sorry for Wanda. Exactly. She would never have paid any attention to Wanda if Peggy had not invented the dresses game. But suppose Peggy and all others started in her next. She wasn't as poor as Wanda Perez, but she was poor, of course. She would have more sense than to say she had 100 dresses. Still, she would not like for them to begin on her. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda. Peggy और Maddie दोनों इसको चिढ़ा रहे. मेडी को अच्छा नहीं लगता, बट मेडी को एक डर है कि वो भी गरीब है. इट इज पॉसिबल दैट फ्रॉम टुमारो पेगी एंड हर फ्रेंड्स माइट स्टॉप टीजिंग वेंडा एंड माइट स्टार्ट ऑन दिस गर्ल मेडी. तो अच्छी बात ये है मेडी को लेकर कि शी इज एटलीस्ट इंटेलिजेंट इनफ टू से दैट शी डज नॉट हैव 100 ड्रेसेस. नहीं है वो क्या ड्रेसेस उसके पास, वो जो है वो बता रहा है, वो झूठ नहीं बोल. लेकिन पर्सनली इंटरनली मेडी डज नॉट लाइक पेगीज टीजिंग वेंडा पैटर्न्स. टुडे इवन दो दे हैड बीन लेट टू स्कूल, मेडी वाज ग्लैड शी हैड नॉट हैड टू मेक फन ऑफ वेंडा. शी वर्कड हर एरिथमेटिक प्रॉब्लम्स एब्सेंट माइंडेडली 8 times 8. लेट अस से शी विश्ड शी हैड द नर्व टू राइट पेगी अ नोट, बिकॉज़ शी न्यू शी नेवर वुड हैव द करेज to speak right out to Peggy to say, hey Peg, let us stop asking Wanda how many dresses she has. Then she finished her arithmetic. She did start a note to Peggy. Maddie चाहती है कि उसमें courage होती तो वो Maddie को Peggy को बोल देती कि Peggy तुम जो कर रही हो वो गलत है. ये चीज तो आपने mathematics arithmetics के सम पूरे कर दिए. अब उसने नोट लिखने का सोचा कि मैं एक नोट लिखती हूँ पेगी. सडनली शी पॉज्ड एंड शडर्ड, अचानक से वो रुक जाती है. शी पिक्चर्ड हरसेल्फ इन द स्कूल यार्ड अ न्यू टारगेट फॉर पेगी एंड द गर्ल्स. पेगी माइट आस्क हर वेयर शी गॉट द ड्रेसेस दैट शी हैड ऑन. मैडी वुड हैव टू से इट वाज वन ऑफ पेगीज ओल्ड वंस दैट मैडीज मदर हैड ट्राइड टू डिस्गाइज विद न्यू ट्रिमिंग, सो नो वन इन रूम 13 would recognize it. क्या होता है, मैगी का ध्यान मेडी का सॉरी ध्यान पढ़ाई में नहीं हो रहा है. ट्राई कर रही है अपने सम्स करने की लेकिन फोकस नहीं हो रहा. नोट लिखने का भी सोचती है पेगी को, रिक्वेस्टिंग हर नोट टू टीज वेंडा एनी मोर एनी फर्दर. तो ये वो सोच रही है लेकिन अचानक से वो रुक जाती है. रुक इसलिए जाती है बिकॉज शी हैज ए फियर. वो अपने आप को इमेजिन करती है कि इंस्टेड ऑफ वेंडा नाउ शी इज द सेंटर, शी इज द लाफिंग स्टॉक फॉर दिस पीपल. और उस वो मेडी को पूछ रहे, ऐसा वो एक सीन इमेजिन कर रही, विजुलाइज कर रही कि अब वो मुझे पूछ रहे कि तुम्हारे पास कितने ड्रेसेस है, ये ड्रेस किसका है. और वो जैसे जवाब दे रही है इमेजिनेशन, ये पेगी के मम्मी ने ही मुझे दिया हुआ एड्रेस है, लेकिन मैंने उसमें ट्रिमिंग्स करके छोटे छोटे पीसेस को अच्छे से डिजाइन करके स्टिच करके कुछ नया अटैच करके अलग कर दिया है, सो दैट इट कैन नॉट बी आइडेंटिफाइड एज द ड्रेस ऑफ पेगी. ऐसा वो अपने आप को विजुलाइज कर रही है. दैट्स व्हाई शी गेट्स स्कैर्ड कि अगर ऐसा सही में हो गया तो क्या होगा. If only Peggy would decide on of her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda, oh well. Maddie ran her hand through her short blonde hair as though to push the uncomfortable thoughts away. What differences did it make? Slowly when it tore into bits the knot she had started. She was Peggy's best friend and Peggy was the best liked girl in the whole room. Peggy could not possibly do anything that was really wrong. अब ओपिनियन चेंज हो जाता है पेगी को लेकर कि पेगी तो अच्छी है, वो तो ऐसा कर ही नहीं सकती, मोस्ट पॉपुलर गर्ल है क्लास की, तो शी कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग रॉन्ग. तो वो नोट जो लिखना चालू किया था उसने फाड़ दिया. एज फॉर वेंडा शी वॉज जस्ट सम गर्ल हु लिव्ड अप ऑन बोगिन्स हाइट्स एंड स्टूड अलोन इन द स्कूल यार्ड. शी स्केर्सली एवर सेड एनीथिंग टू एनीबॉडी. द ओनली टाइम शी टॉक्ड वाज इन द स्कूल यार्ड अबाउट हर 100 ड्रेसेस. Maddie remembered her telling about one of her dresses, pale blue with colored trimmings. And she remembered another that was brilliant jungle green with a red sash. You would look like a Christmas tree in that, the girls had said in pretended admiration. Venda ki baat kare, to ek aisi ladki hai jo ek ordinary ilake mein rehti hai, school mein akeli khadi rehti hai, baithti hai. She has no friend, wagera wagera. Haan, Maddie ko yaad aata ek time, jab मैट किसी वो सब उसको पूछ रहे थे ड्रेस को लेकर, तो एक जंगल ग्रीन ड्रेस की भी बात हुई थी. तो किसी ने वेंडा की मजाक उड़ाते हुए कहा था कि ये जंगल ग्रीन कलर जो है अगर तुम पहनोगी तो तुम बिल्कुल क्रिसमस ट्री जैसी लगोगी. थिंकिंग अबाउट वेंडा एंड 100 ड्रेसेस ऑल लाइंड अप इन द क्लोजेट, मैडी बिगन टू वंडर हु वाज गोइंग टू विन द ड्रॉइंग एंड कलरिंग कॉन्टेस्ट. For girls, this contest consisted of designing dresses, and for boys, of designing motorboats. Probably Peggy would win the girls' medal. Peggy drew better than anyone else in the room. At least that is what everybody thought. She could copy a picture in a magazine or some film star's hat, so that you could almost tell who it was. Oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winner. Then they would know. अब वेंडा के बारे में सोचते हुए पेगी के बारे में ये सारा सोचते सोचते अचानक से मैडी रिमेंबर्स द कंपटीशन दैट वाज हेल्ड अर्लियर. तो वो सोचने लगी कि कंपटीशन जीतेगा, कहती है कि पेगी ही जीतेगा, जीतेगी क्योंकि वो बेस्ट करती है ड्राइंग. किसी का हेड अगर ड्रॉ करती है तो भी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट वन कैन आइडेंटिफाई कि ये किसी फेमस पर्सनैलिटी का हेड. तो शी वाज श्योर दैट पेगी वाज गोइंग टू. Anyway, teacher was going to announce the next day. The next day it was drizzling, धीरे-धीरे बारिश हो रही थी. Maddie and Peggy hurried to school under Peggy's umbrella. Naturally, on a day like this, they did not wait for Venda Petrovsky on the corner of Oliver Street, the street that far, far away under the railroad tracks and up the hill led to Boggins' site. Anyway, they were not taking chances of being late today because today was important. Next day, Peggy and Maddie's school जा रही है, उन्होंने वेट करना नहीं सही समझा क्योंकि आज रिजल्ट निकले होने. Do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today? Asked Peggy. Oh, I hope so. The minute we get it, said Maddie. Of course you will win. Hope so, said Peggy. The minute they entered the classroom, they stopped short and gasped. There were drawings all over the room, on every ledge and windowsill, dazzling colors and brilliant lavish designs. All drawn on great sheets of wrapping papers. There must have been 100 of them, all lined up. These must be the drawings for the contest. They were everybody stopped and whistled or murmured admiringly. सब क्लास में गए एकदम जैसे ही क्लास में एंटर हुए रुक गए और ऐसे देखने माय गुडनेस इतने अच्छे अच्छे ड्रॉइंग्स थे क्लास में एकदम मस्त ब्रिलियंट कलर से पेंट किए हुए डिजाइन किए हुए अच्छी अच्छी डिजाइन थी. So, सोचा कि ये सारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स की रीजन है. As soon as the class had assembled, Miss Mason announced the winner. Jack Beggars had won for the boys, and his design for an outboard motor was on exhibition in room 12, along with the sketches by all other boys. As for the girls, she said, although just one or two sketches were submitted by most, one girl in room 13 should be proud of her. This one girl actually drew 100 designs. All different and all beautiful. In the opinion of judges, any one of the drawing is worthy of winning the prize. I am very happy to say that Venda is the winner of the girls' medal. Unfortunately, Venda has been absent from school for some day and is not here to receive the applause that is due to her. Let us hope she will be back tomorrow. Now, class, you may file around room quietly and look at her exquisite. Drawings. The children burst into applause and even the boys were glad to have a chance to stamp on the floor, put their fingers in their mouth and whistle, though they were not interested in dresses. "Look, Peg," whispered Maddie. "That is that blue one she told us about. Isn't it beautiful?" "Yes. And here's the green one. Boy, I thought I could draw." क्लास में गए, बहुत सारे डिजाइन थे कि टीचर ने बोला कि बॉयज में जैक बेगल्स नाम का लड़का जीता है, और गर्ल्स की बात करें तो एक लड़की जब जाए, बाकी रेस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स हैड पार्टिसिपेटेड एंड हैड सबमिटेड वन और टू और थ्री एंट्रीज, दिस गर्ल हैज सबमिटेड 100 डिजाइंस। अकॉर्डिंग टू जज, ऑल डिजाइंस आर ब्यूटीफुल एंड वर्थ ऑफ गेटिंग प्राइजेस। शी इज वेंडा पेट्रोंस्की, हु इज द विनर। अभी हमारे साथ नहीं है, लेकिन जब आएगी तो उसका जो मेडल है वो दे देंगे। बाद में शी इन्फॉर्म द क्लास कि चलो सब अलग अलग रूम नंबर में जाओ और सारी डिजाइंस देखो। और एक ड्रेस को देखकर देखा, एक ग्रीन, वो सब याद है तुमको? तो क्या, हाँ याद है। पेगी कहती है, ऐसा तो मैं भी ड्रॉ कर सकती हूँ। ठीक है, यहाँ पर पार्ट पूरा वन होता है, पार्ट वन पूरा होता है, और पार्ट टू हम थोड़ी देर के बाद चलो।